Hello! In the second puzzle video, I showed you some differences between all those angles when you do compression in different ways. Today let's go a little bit deeper, and I will show you some more examples how the hip compression looks in practice. The main difference between these two compressions is the upper body position. When you do a knee compression, your upper body is much more vertical than in a hip compression case, when your upper body goes more or less horizontally in relation to the deck plane. The knees bend in both cases, but when we decompress, the knees lift your body weight in the knee decompression case. And when you decompress from the hips, the knees give stability and balance to your body, but they are not much involved in lifting your body weight. Very important thing if you try to do the hip compression is the shape of your back. To avoid the back pain or spinal disc herniation, the lower back should be straight or even curved a little in this way, following natural lumbar curvature. And I strongly recommend you to avoid this shape of your back. Now let's see how I ride the surfskate focusing on the hip compression. I am not in my best shape yet, after the break of 3 winter months. But I hope you will understand better how the hip compression works for speed generation and tense.